Hey, what's going on everybody? My name is Jay Cruz and welcome back to another video. In this one, I'm going to put two of my favorite overdrive pedals head to head, the Jay Chess Morning Glory versus the Jackson Audio Broken Arrow. Let's get it. You guys know the deal. Please do all of the things that help this channel grow. Like this video, comment and subscribe, hit the bell notification icon so you get an alert every single time I upload a video. Without further ado, let's get started. So this whole mess started a few weeks ago when I put some gear up for sale. I actually still have that gear up for sale. If you're interested, I'll put a link in the description box below that'll lead you to my Reverb account. In the list of gear that I put for sale, I actually listed my beloved JHS Morning Glory. And some of you went kind of crazy. You were DMing me, asking me why I was selling that pedal. You couldn't believe that I was selling that pedal because it was so much a part of my everyday tone. Truth be told, I've actually owned and sold a JHS Morning Glory in different forms, mind you, but I've had it before and got rid of it before, so I've never been too scared to get rid of it. I've never felt like the pedal was so, like, rare that I couldn't get my hands on it again if I needed to. But to be honest with you, I'm trying to sell off some stuff to fund my tone journey. This pedal board build trickled into me wanting to explore tones even from my guitar perspective. So I've been getting different guitars in here as well to try different tones out, try different things. It's not to say that my Nash T52 is going anywhere, but I decided I wanted to explore different tonal options. So to help with some of those purchases, I put up some gear for sale and the Morning Glory was one of them. But those people who DM'd me really got me thinking, do I really want to give this pedal up? I mean, I have it for sale still, but it really does sound great. So today I'm going to compare the tones that I get from the JHS Morning Glory directly with the Jackson Audio Broken Arrow, which is the pedal that replaced all of my overdrives. If you haven't seen my latest rig rundown, go ahead and check it out. I'll link it right up here. It's actually doing really well from a views standpoint, so I want to thank all of you who have watched that video. Maybe you're new here from that video, so thank you. Welcome to the channel. And today we're gonna do some tone searching. So of course, I'm gonna be using the Nash T52 here as always, and I'm gonna just turn some pedals on and see what kind of tones we get. So just to give you a little bit of a tone reference, I am using compression, a little bit of compression from the Jackson Audio Bloom. It's how I typically run overdrives, especially for the kind of music that I tend to play. I'm going into the HX stomp, but I'm gonna turn off reverbs and delays for now. Maybe I'll turn them on later on in the video just to get a little bit of an understanding of how the drives interact with those kinds of effects. But for now, we're gonna go dry straight into the amps. This is my clean sound. Now we're going to turn on the Morning Glory. As you can see, my settings on the screen, my volume is at about 12 o'clock, and really that's just to match the volume of where I want my drives to be. I have the drive set at about 11 o'clock and the tone set at about 2 o'clock. Let's hear that same sound on the neck position. Now I want to switch over to the red setting on the JHS Morning Glory. I do have JHS's red remote here, which toggles between the blue and red setting. So we're going to switch over. I'm going to go to my bridge pickup and let's hear what that extra little boost of gain sounds like. Now I'm gonna quickly turn on the Jackson Audio Broken Arrow. Here's the blue setting set at 25% of the gain that I have set. All of my settings you can see on the screen. As you can see, the gain is set pretty low on this pedal. To be honest with you, when I first set this pedal up, the idea was to sort of tone match what I was getting with the JHS Morning Glory without necessarily directly copying it. So you might hear some similarities in the way that it's set up. Thank you. Now let's switch to the neck position. To sort of emulate what I did by switching over to the red setting on the JHS Morning Glory, I'm actually going to switch to my third stage drive here, which is actually the green setting on the Broken Arrow at 50% of the overdrive that is available. Now, before I give you my thoughts on each pedal, I want to quickly go back and forth on the sound so you could hear them back to back. Blue setting on the Morning Glory. Blue setting on the Broken Arrow. Red setting on the Morning Glory. Green setting set on the Broken Arrow. For me, the shootout is very, very interesting. I like how, first of all, both pedals sound amazing to me. They both sound really, really amazing. Clearly, I'm the guy who set them both up, right? Because I think that even just by playing through them, I can hear similarities in both tone. So clearly I have a preference in how I like to set up my drives because they're set up very, very the same. For today's purposes, I actually barely touched either one of those pedals. I actually placed them on my board here almost exactly how I left them the last time I played each of them in separate occasions. So it's pretty amazing how similar they sound right now as I'm playing through them. The JHS Morning Glory has a natural fullness that I really enjoy. There's something about it. Obviously, if I lower the gain a little bit, it'll clean up very, very well, be your typical what is considered in today's standards a transparent overdrive. But as you can hear, as you boost the gain, as you push the pedal a little bit more, it can definitely get into this really beautiful saturation sound that takes on its own sort of voicing that I really, really enjoy as well. It's a simple pedal in terms that it only has a tone knob. It doesn't have a three-band EQ like the Broken Arrow does, but it doesn't seem to be something that I'm missing. The tone knob really covers all of my needs personally. It may not be the pedal for everyone else, but for me, it was definitely hitting home. And though it's sold as a transparent pedal, I do feel like it has this sort of natural mid-range thing that is familiar sounding to me personally, that kind of puts it in the Klon-ish territory. Maybe not as warm sounding or thick sounding, but with an adjustment of the tone knob, you can definitely get there, and which is why I enjoy this pedal. A direct comparison to the Broken Arrow starts off as a more of like a clean palette, in my opinion. I could have probably either boosted the gain on the Broken Arrow or lowered the gain on the Morning Glory to sort of match them a little bit more in terms of gain. But one thing I found was that I liked the way they were set as individuals, and I don't know, they sounded great to me. The Broken Arrow was a little more focused and it had a little more definition. Maybe didn't have quite as much body as the JHS Morning Glory did, but I didn't necessarily miss that body, especially in the mix. The more definition and clarity, typically, the easier it is for you to cut through a mix. And it's not like the Broken Arrow is razor thin where you feel like you're playing paper distortion. We've all had those kind of products, whether it was a cheap amp or a not so great pedal, but this one is not like that at all, but it just has a little bit of a different voicing is all. The only way to truly compare that switch that the JHS Morning Glory does from the blue setting to the red setting is by actually switching the Broken Arrow settings as well. I can either toggle up the gain or just switch it, as you saw what I did, the overall clipping option altogether. For me, the saturation reminded me of a Tube Screamer-esque type of a pedal. I decided to jump to the green setting, which essentially is sort of a Tube Screamer-esque type of sound without the mid boost. And so it was similar sounding to my ear. There's where I actually think the Broken Arrow had the more bottom end versus the JHS Morning Glory. The funny thing about both pedals is that if you try to make adjustments to one of those sounds, you're gonna alter the adjustments of the other sound that you maybe love. So if I add more bottom end to that red setting, I'm essentially altering the setting on my blue setting of the JHS Morning Glory, which will then kind of ruin that sound that I have. It'll make it probably a little bit too bottom end heavy. Whereas with the Broken arrow. There's a little more versatility there. I don't necessarily need to jump to the green setting. I can gain cycle if I wanted to directly in the blue setting like I was using at that moment. I also have different options. And that's where this pedal clearly becomes a little more versatile. The amount of options that you get with the Broken Arrow. It's not just one overdrive or one type of voicing, it's multiple overdrives in one. Essentially multiple voicings with the ability to gain cycle within the gain that you set. It's a genius invention, and I can't get over how versatile this thing is. Especially version 2 of this pedal, which is the one I'm using, it's MIDI compatible, which means that I can use my Morningstar MC6 to gain cycle or to pull up any one of the gains that I want to. Whereas the JHS Morning Glory, it's not. But the Red Remote makes it just as versatile, and you can call upon those two tones very, very easily without any kind of issues. So it's not like the JHS Morning Glory is lacking versatility either. It's just not quite as wide range as the Broken Arrow. Head-to-head competition, I love them both, but I'm definitely loving the tones that I'm getting with the Broken Arrow. The fact that it can cover more dynamic range for me is a plus versus the JHS Morning Glory, which was always kind of, I don't want to use the word one trick pony, but it did what it did and I loved it for what it did. At the end of the day, one pedal for me isn't better than the other per se in terms of tone wise. It's just this point in my life, I want to explore different options, and the Broken Arrow is providing me that opportunity as opposed to the Morning Glory, which I've basically had for a number of years now. So I just want to go a different direction with my tone, and that's the reason why I'm sticking with the Broken Arrow. Guys, I hope this video has helped maybe make some decisions or at least get some clarity into what you think these pedals will sound like in your hands. Let me know in the comment section what you think of them, which one you think you could vibe with a little bit more with your current setup. Please don't forget to do all of the things that help this channel grow. Like this video, comment and subscribe below, hit the bell notification icon so you get an alert every single time I upload a video. You can also check out some of the affiliate links in the description box below. Clicking on those links will help kick some money back into this channel, which is greatly appreciated. Thanks again for watching, and until next week.